As we said, as you no doubt heard, the man in charge of the Mueller investigation preparing to resign, Rod Rosenstein, a Harvard-educated career Justice Department lawyer, expected to step down on his own terms, but apparently will not leave Robert Mueller high and dry. This is according to NBC News reporting today, quote, a source close to Rosenstein said he intends to stay on until Mueller's investigative and prosecutorial work is done. The source said once Mueller's work is done, special counsel's report to the Justice Department would follow a few weeks later, and Rosenstein would likely be gone by then. The timing of all of this unclear, and there's reporting all over the map regarding how far along that man might be in his investigation. If confirmed, and his hearings start next week, the incoming AG William Barr would oversee the Russia investigation, even though he wrote in a now famous and unsolicited memo that the Mueller investigation was ill-conceived and, quote, Mueller should not be permitted to demand that the president submit to interrogation about alleged obstruction. Well, with us to talk about all of it tonight, the attorney Neal Katyal. He served as the government's top lawyer before the Supreme Court, acting Solicitor General during the Obama administration. In that capacity, argued 37 cases before the Supreme Court. Perhaps most notably, he's a veteran of the DOJ, where he drafted the special counsel regulations under which Mr. Mueller was appointed. Counselor, thank you very much for coming back on our broadcast. As always, what do you make of the Rosenstein departure? Do you think too much has been made of it? Do you think anyone's really going to harm a hair on Mueller's head?
I think it's pretty significant and worrisome. So Rosenstein is the kind of key man under the special counsel regulations, because the special counsel regulations say that the attorney general, or if the attorney general is recused, the acting attorney general supervises the investigation. And by all accounts, Rosenstein has let Mueller do his job unimpeded, taking the investigation where it leads and so on. But the attorney general, or the acting attorney general, has a vast suite of powers under the special counsel regulations. He can, for example, stop any investigation, stop any subpoena or calling of someone. He could say you can't indict a certain person, whether it be Don Jr. or Jared or even the president. And most notably, he could try and block the final report about the investigation from the public and from Congress. And so those are all tools that the attorney general does have. They're subject to some limitations. But as we think about Rosenstein departing and we think about being replaced by currently this acting attorney general, fake attorney general Whitaker, and now Barr, both of whom have campaigned or auditioned for the job of attorney general by writing opinions or giving speeches or giving media interviews in which they say Mueller is a problem. I mean, this is, I think, very, very unseemly to have someone like that supervising this investigation.
Does that mean we're going to have a Sessions-like conversation all over again if Barr is confirmed, if he's already prejudged the investigation? Should he recuse himself from anything to do with the Russia investigation?
I do think that that's going to be a very serious question. And notably, Whitaker, the current acting attorney general, went and sought advice from the ethics office at the Justice Department. Those are people I worked with all the time. They're career people. They're totally respectable and very diligent in what they do. And they said to Whitaker, evidently, don't do this. And he went ahead and did it anyway. And so I don't have any confidence in the Trump administration's new person to do anything different, because their modus operandi has been to basically blow off the ethics and do whatever it takes to protect the hide of Donald Trump. And, you know, Barr's memo is a really good example of that. That is a memo that I actually think many of my first year law students would have done a better job. Barr is a very smart man, but that is a willful, deliberate document designed to give the president a get out of jail free card.
I have to get you on the record on this Manafort news. This was the story yesterday. I heard you on a lesser network tonight, made me laugh out loud when you said, who among us hasn't passed voter intel on to a Russian overseas from inside a presidential campaign? You were kidding, obviously. What do you think is going on here?
Well, it's hard to know, Brian, but boy, it sure does seem really significant. The idea that the president, Manafort's not just some guy on a campaign, he's the president's top campaign official, the number one, numero uno, and he is taking secret campaign information and giving it to the Russians. There's something, you know, where the Ukrainians, you know, there's some dispute about that. But either way, it is highly unusual, and I can't really make much sense of it except to think that, you know, this is part of an orchestrated plot to feed information, big data information, to the Russians so to allow them to help the campaign. Now, maybe there's some other explanation. He's obviously entitled to presumption of doubt and so, you know, to reasonable doubt and all the other criminal protections. But it sure looks suspicious. And there's one other thing that's important, which is Mueller himself thinks this is suspicious because Manafort had pled guilty months ago. And then Mueller found out about these lies about the Ukrainians and about this voting information and revoked the plea deal. And so he found that, you know, to use a legal word, material to the overall investigation. And so there's something here. We don't know exactly what, but boy, it looks terrible for Manafort. And I suspect it looks bad for Donald Trump.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.